is very odd to introduce a very nice problem of African Mathematical Olympiad, Mozambique, edition 2003, question number one. Okay, here is the following information. Find all functions f. We have this application n to n, such that we have f of 2 equals 2 as a first condition, and also we have f, and also we have this inequality f of n is strictly inferior than f of n plus 1. Okay, so the third condition we have this. The third condition, we have f of mn equals f of m is multiplied by f of n for all mn as natural numbers. Okay, in fact this is very nice and straightforward problem, so I would recommend to give the chart to this problem prior to getting to the solution. Go ahead, pause this video when we come back to see the full solution. Okay, now let's jump into the solution. So we have f of n is strictly inferior than f of n plus 1. This one is telling us f is increasing function. F of, if you take n equals 1, it's giving you f of 1 is strictly inferior f of 2. F of 2 is strictly inferior to f of 3. F of 3 is strictly inferior to f of 4, and so on and so forth. That means this function is increasing function. Okay? Now I'm going to work on this inequality. Okay? We have f of n is strictly inferior than f of n plus 1 is the same as f of n plus 1 is strictly superior than f of n. Okay, so I'm going to bring this f of n to the left. I will get f of n plus 1 minus f of n is strictly superior than 0. Okay, if I want number 1 will be included here, I'm going to put this one as f of n plus 1 minus f of n is superior equal to 1, like this. Okay, this one is telling us this is equivalent f of n plus 1 minus f of n equals 1, or f of n plus 1 minus f of n is strictly superior than 1, like this. I'm going to force this one to be out of this possibility. Okay, so by the way of contradiction, suppose f of n plus 1 minus f of n is strictly superior than 1. Okay, then I'm going to push this one to the right. I will get f of n plus 1 is superior equal to f of n plus number 1. Okay, like this. I'm going to replace n with number 1. I'm going to take n equals 1 to see what's giving us. I will have f of 2 is strictly superior than f of 1 plus number 1. Okay, we have f of 2 equals 2 as a given information. Then I'm going to take this number 1 to the left. I will get 2 minus 1, which equals 1, is strictly superior than f of 1. Okay, like this. Since we have f is increasing function, we have 1 is strictly superior than f of 1. That means f of 1 equals 0, which is impossible. This is contradiction. Okay, that means this one is ruled out of this possibility. Okay, that means this one is not valid, so I'm going to take this one. Okay, so I have f of n plus 1 minus f of n equals 1. Okay, I'm going to replace n with number 1. If n equals 1, I will have f of 2 minus f of 1 equals 1. Okay, then I'm going to take this one to the right. I will get f of 2 equals f of 1 plus number 1. Okay, as we know, f of 2 equals 2 as a given information. This one is telling us by taking this number 1 to the left, I will get f of 1 equals 1. Here is the first value, f of 1 equals 1. Okay, so on the other hand, since we have increasing function, since f is increasing function, okay, so I will have f of 2 is strictly inferior than f of 3 and is strictly inferior than f of 4, like this. Okay, We know this value f of 2 equals 2. So I'm going to calculate this one. I'm going to use this fact. We have f of m equals f of m is multiplied by f of n. I'm going to write this one on this form. I will have f of 2 is multiplied by 2 like this, which equals f of 2 is multiplied by f of 2. We already give us f of 2 equals 2, which means 2 is multiplied by 2, which is 4. Now I found the value of f of 4 equals 4, which means since this application is given as a natural number as output, and this f of 3 is lying between two consecutive integers, that's mean equals 3, okay? Because this one equals 2, this one equals 4, which means f of 3 equals 3. This one is telling us f of 3 equals 3, okay? Also, we found f of 4 equals 4, okay? On the other hand, we have f of 4 is strictly inferior than f of 5, is strictly inferior than f of 6, is strictly inferior than f of 7, and is strictly inferior than f of 8. Okay? Because we have increasing function. Okay? We know this value, f of 4 equals 4. Now we need to calculate f of 6. F of 6 by using this fact is the same as f of 6 is the same as 2 is multiplied by 3, which is f of 2 is multiplied by f of 3. We know the value of f of 2, which equals 2 as a given information. We know also f of 3 equals 3. That means 2 is multiplied by 3, which is 6. Now I found the value of f of 6 equals 6. Since f of 5 is lying between two consecutive integers, that means f of 5 equals 5 as well. Okay? So we know the value of f of 5 equals 5, and we know f of 6 equals 6. I'm going to calculate f of 8. F of 8, I'm going to use the same fact here. F of 8 equals f of 2 is multiplied by 4, which equals f of 2 is multiplied by f of 4. Okay? We know f of 2 equals 2, and we know f of 4 equals 4, which equals 8. Okay? Now we know the value of f of 8 equals 8. Okay? Since f of 7 is lying between two consecutive integers, okay, that means f of 7 equals 7, because we know f of 6 equals 6, we know f of 8 equals 8, that means f of 7 equals 7. Previously, we have calculated f of 1 through f of 8. We found that every individual input is giving us the same output, okay? From f of 1 through f of 8 and so on and so forth. In addition, we have this inequality as a condition. We have f of n minus 1 is strictly inferior than f of n is strictly inferior than f of n plus 1, because we have f is increasing function, okay? Also, by using this pattern, f of 1 is strictly inferior than f of 2 is strictly inferior than f of 3, like this, and so on and so forth, like this, okay? So by this application, we found every individual put is lying between two consecutive integers, okay? We found like f of 3 equals 3. And this one found f of 1 equals 1. That means this one is arithmetically equals 2. Okay? The same thing on the same application is applying on this general formula. We have f of n is lying between f of n minus 1 and f of n plus 1. By using this pattern, we found f of n minus 1 must be equals n minus 1. And also f of n plus 1 must equals n plus 1. That means f of n is lying between two consecutive integers. That means f of n must be equals n. Finally, thus, f of n equals n for all natural numbers, okay? Not included zero, because we have a natural number, okay? So I have done this problem. If you are interested in watching this one, don't forget to support us with a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching. I will see you next video. Bye.